we've talked a little bit about the corruption of the police force, late 1800s through Prohibition, but this was something that was part of Portland all the way up through the 1950s. Between illegal gambling, opium dens, prostitution, everything was just a little shady, and the police were in on most of it. This got to be such a problem on a national level of cities having corrupt police forces that the US government decided to do a crackdown, and Portland was one of the first cities to fall under scrutiny. These were the McClellan trials. They did take place in Washington, D.C., and people were brought in from the city, whether they were on the police force, other witnesses, politicians. But the number one witness for Portland's part of the trial was a man named Jim Elkins, also known as Big Jim, and he was not a politician or policeman or your regular everyday citizen. He was actually a crime boss. And he basically ratted out everyone who was in competition with him. He got the US government to clear out all of his competition in the city. He came back to Portland and decided it was time to retire. I don't really blame him. He went down to Arizona, lived his retirement for a couple months, and then sadly was found dead in his car. He seemed to have had a heart attack and ran into a tree. That was the official report. One of the paramedics who were on the scene at the time is reported to have said, well, if he did have a heart attack, it was probably caused by all those bullets in his chest. So it's one of those things where crime doesn't pay, even if you try to get out of town.